What's up, guys? Steve here with Soul Lifts and Ed working out together, doing some chest workout. I'm doing some band warm-ups here with Ed in high speed. I'll show you a couple different angles of that. If you're going to do chest, shoulders, anything where you're going to put a lot of pressure on the rotator cuff, make sure that you're doing your due diligence and spending an appropriate amount of time warming up. So this is just some of what we did for our warm-up. So once I was finished with the bands, I hung down from the TRX rack here and did some shoulder dislocations as well, which really helped set up for the bench. Moving over to bench, our first exercise of the day was flat bench, starting with some warm-up sets here. Convinced Ed to do some reverse pyramid training with me for a change and see how that worked out for him. So we did some warm-ups here, 60 by 5. I'm moving the bench around because it's not in line with the lines on the ceiling. Sometimes it can kind of mess you up for keeping the bar straight on the way up and down. So I want to make sure that the bench is aligned with whatever the pipes or lines are in the ceiling. So here's Ed doing his 60 by 5 warm-up. Now, Ed prefers a suicide grip here, which is where the thumbs are not wrapped around the bar. I would personally recommend it, but that's what he's comfortable with. You don't want to drop the bar on yourself like that, so I always make sure my thumbs are wrapped around. This is my second warm-up set here, 100 by 3. And Ed's going to do a warm-up as well by 3. Apparently, Ed had worked his triceps the day before, so it was a bit tight on one side. This is my last warm-up, a single at 120. And Ed doing his last warm-up here at 100. This is the heavy single of the day. It was 130. I'm still sick. I don't know if you can hear my voice or not. 130 was about all I had juice on today. And, it was heavy. So these days, my workouts aren't going quite as heavy as I'd like to. And I'm attributing that probably to being sick. So I'm going to pop a rep out there, 110. And I'm going to start working down here, doing a set 120 by 3. And as we're spotting each other here, you'll notice through the video here, he's not actually lifting the bar. His hands are there, but he's not lifting the bar for me. We're gonna help each other rack into position, get the bar off the rack and then straight down. And I'm also similarly not lifting the bar for him, following it with my hands, yes, but as I've said in other videos, bench pressing, not a team sport. So as you're spotting somebody, please make sure that they're completing the lift by themselves. And it's a good example here. So I can't actually hear Ed because I've got my headphones in at the time, but I'm sure he's shouting encouragement as the bar's coming up and down. So he's not actually doing a lift for me, but making sure that safety's being attended to. I'll make sure he's getting into position nicely. And as the weights come down, we're doing progressively lighter and lighter sets here. Reverse pyramid training, and again, if you haven't seen the video on RPT or reverse pyramid training, check elsewhere on the channel, you'll find it. Basically, we're starting with our warm-up sets and then working from our heaviest set down towards our lightest. And this is how we're going to finish up flat bench here. This is my last set on flat bench, my lightest set on flat bench here. I'm going to almost rep out at 80 by 10. And just until I can feel the burn. I don't want to completely go to failure on this because we still have other exercises to do, but I do want to go to failure on those heavier sets, which you saw earlier. And here's Ed's last set. And he doesn't much need my help on this. And again, if you pay attention to his grip, he doesn't have his thumbs wrapped around the bar. I would definitely suggest wrapping the thumbs around the bar, but different strokes for different folks, right? He feels that he gets a little bit more out of this. I know Big J, benches the same way, but safety in mind, I suggest you wrap your thumbs around the bar. Moving over to dumbbell bench, And it's nice, this new gym has 40 kilo dumbbells, and the last one only had 35, so it was nice to get a little bit of a heavier one. You'll see a little wobble of the dumbbell. I want to make sure you got your grip right. And as I'm coming down, you know, Ed's there to support the elbows, but he's not actually completing the lift at all and letting me do the work. So I did 10 with 240 kilo dumbbells, which is good to get a little bit heavier than usual. And Ed, who normally trains for that sarcoplasmic hypertrophy, those the bodybuilder muscles, decided he was going to go ahead and give a try at some heavier weights here. So he gave a try with the 40s as well, and ditched the hoodie for his sexy 1980s workout shirt with the spaghetti strap stuff. The dog apparently agrees. All right, so second set here. Dumbbell bench, and these are the heaviest sets. We already warmed up with the flat bench enough because this is a similar motion, so I stayed with the 40s on this before dropping the weight down in future sets. Ed's second set coming down in weight. He's got some elbow wraps on. When I eventually do take off the hoodie, I wasn't so hot today. I've got my standard blue wrist wraps on, or elbow wraps on, and some wrist support as well. You don't necessarily need gloves for this, but if you're going to go heavy with a bench or pressing motion, you probably want to have some good wrist support. On this set, as I'm coming down, I got 236K dumbbells, and I'm going to do this Arnold style. So as I come up, and as you've seen in some other videos, I'm going to twist the outside ends of the dumbbells together, and it's going to give a squeeze right between the pectoral muscles. This is just an alternative way to do your dumbbell benches. He's going to make a bit of a face for you there. And continuing on with some dumbbell benches. Again, I'm there to support him in case there's some kind of failure problem, but this weight isn't super heavy, so he seems to be doing all right. I'm just there to catch him if anything goes wrong. Now I like to start my press from the bottom of the movement, like so. And if you watch the next set for Ed here, he actually likes to start at the top of the movement. My weights are coming down here, so I'm not struggling as much to bump the weight up. But if you watch the last set that Ed's going to do here, I'm going to help him lift up. As soon as he drops back, I'm going to help him lift up the weights. And he's going to start from the top of the motion. I prefer to start from the bottom, but whatever works best for you. Again, first rep, I'm going to support him to get the weight up there, and then he's going to really start his set from the top of the movement. And it's going to end up being our last set with the flat dumbbell bench press. I moved over to one of my favorites. This is the hammer strength iso-lateral plate loaded decline chest press, which is a long name for the machine. I'm going to start with a warm-up set here at 123 by 5, and it's going to we're going to drop the weight a little bit here. Nice thing about working out with a partner, and I normally don't, is that changing the weights keeps the rest times short. You do have to wait for your partner to finish their sets, but not having to truck the weights around as much is nice, especially in a gym the size of mine now, where we're going to have to import the plates from all the way across the floor. That could be a bit of a drag to carry them around. So it's nice to have a workout partner for that. So working on the decline first. I'm moving up to my heavy set here. Four plates aside, this was real heavy for 163. That last rep was a real struggle. Might even be call it 2.5 there. It's doing real well here, keeping his elbows down. If your elbows come too far up, putting a lot of pressure on the shoulder, and at the end of the video, it'll talk a little bit about planes of motion as well. I'm trying to remember to keep my elbows down so that I don't power through the motion too much with the shoulders and put too much strain on the rotator cuff. So we're starting to work down our sets here from heavy down to lighter. I try to go towards failure on these. We started with the free weights because it engages a lot of the stabilization and support muscles, and then moved over to these range of motion plate loaded machines, which focus more directly on the pectoral muscles and take a lot of the stabilizing muscles out of it. So they're good for assistance work. But you know, once again, you probably want to keep your big lifts, your free weight lifts, as your main exercises, and do them first before you exhaust the muscles and use these as assistance exercises afterwards. So we moved over to the incline machine. Same company. This is a hammer strength, plate loaded iso-lateral incline chest press. And again, try not to flare the elbows up too much. And use too much of the shoulders, and keep a good plane of motion there. So I'm trying to remember keep my elbows down. I don't want to put too much pressure on my rotator cuff. And this, I believe, was my heavy set at 124. And talking about tightening up the lats before starting to press motion, and. You know, his range of motion is coming to 90 degrees on the elbow. You don't need to bring it too much past that. There's a bit of a stretch there if you do. But if you are simply working on your pectoral muscles, you don't really need to bring it back too far. So again, working down on the weights. And this is going to hit the top of the pec. More specifically. And Ned's going to do this as his last set at 60 plus the four that the machine's already worth. And my last burnout set here, and I'm going to do a bit of work with some cadence. So I'm going to let it down slow, explode up with it, which gives just a little bit more strain on the muscle. Last exercise of the day, we moved over to the chest press machine. This is we did this in lieu of a pec deck, cable flies, cable chest flies, we'll call it. I did three sets. I only recorded two here. We actually pyramided the weights up for this last one. Not going too heavy. This is a decent machine. You know, it allows you to control the angle with which you hit the muscle pretty well. It doesn't put quite as much strain on the shoulder, I find, as it's a traditional chest fly machine. Is that doing another set and really focusing on a squeeze at the top of his movement. He's going to rotate his hands in. You don't have to. And here's Ed. He's going to talk a bit about planes of movement. What he wants to say is if your elbows come up too much, you're going to be more shoulder dominant. You can see where his if he's got his elbows up too much, the delts are engaging, but the pectorals are not. And if his motion is too low, it's going to collapse the chest and really be more tricep dominant. So he wants to make sure that he's got a plane of motion right in the middle there, not bringing his elbows up too much, not rotating his elbows up too much. He wants a straight, flat plane of motion, which is, and that doesn't, you know, that could be for an incline motion or for a decline motion, but he wants to control where your elbows are located, how your elbows are twisted. The audio wasn't so great on this one here, but he's trying to say if he's rotating his elbows up too much here, that his chest is going to collapse and put a lot of pressure on his shoulder. So instead, he wants to keep his elbows in a nice straight flat plane of motion coming back. It's a bit difficult, he's saying, to do the incline with the elbows too far down. But that's it. That's our workout for the day. Thanks to Ed for showing up and doing that with me. And to stay tuned for his videos in the future. Subscribe to the channel, like the video, comment below, check out the workout details here. And until next time, keep growing.